The amazing run-up for commodities have stalled in the last week or so, with concerns that China is about to raise interest rates. Is this just a small setback in the long-term picture, or is there a real reason to sell? Well, Nick McGregor joins us now from Redmayne Bentley. Nick, welcome. Is this a good reason to sell after all the gains we've had, or is there a real worry now about the high levels of commodity prices that we've seen? I mean, just to mention some, record highs for gold, cotton, copper, I mean, the list goes on.
It depends entirely on where you're coming at it from. The underlying factors that have driven those rises are still there. We are still seeing consuming nations such as China with rising demand and so on. But of course, if China raises its rates to try and curb that growth and manage that growth in the shorter term, it'll certainly have an impact on demand and on speculative money, which will look for another home elsewhere.
Is the drop that we've seen in some of the commodities justified? I mean, we've seen sugar down recently by a record 12% in London at one point. Cotton, as we said earlier, record highs recently, falling by the maximum limit amount allowed in China. Crude oil down by the widest margin in 3 weeks. These are some big declines.
They are big declines, but put against the backdrop of how quickly some of these commodity prices have risen over recent months, then in that context, they're not so alarming. Of course, what we get is as speculative money starts to come in, it creates a more volatile market. And that really is just a symptom of this. It doesn't necessarily actually interrupt the bear trend, the bull trend in those commodities. It just gives it a little bit of breathing space to move on from here.
But we can be confident, can we, that there's not a bubble building here, or hasn't been a bubble building?
Well, the concern, of course, is that prices become unsustainable and then there will be a serious correction. That's very much down to those consuming nations and whether their growth figures live up to expectations. So again, the market's looking very much at India, China and so on, and whether or not those GDP figures continue to grow at expected rates.
Are we just not producing enough? Is there, in certain cases of resources, of course, that it's a situation where copper, for example, ultimately one day it will run out, and we can keep on growing cotton there.
Absolutely, and agricultural softer commodities tend to have less dependence on that because, of course, those who grow these things look very carefully at prices and they will switch production across to those commodities where demand is highest when prices are good. For hard commodities such as metals and so on, the picture is much more difficult. It's a big infrastructure project to bring on stream new capacity, and as you say, ultimately there is a finite amount of these things that one can get out of the ground. So at some point we're likely to see those two trends diverge, and probably a more assertive bull run on extractive industry commodities compared to soft commodities from the agricultural sector.
We've seen a lot of cases where there's been a lot of inventory run out, but people have they've not been supplying fast enough, and the inventory's run down. What does what we've seen this drop in the commodity markets mean for companies producing them? Is there going to be a meaningful drop off in their profitability over the next few years because of this, and worries that commodities are too high? Those companies that can't switch, for example.
Well, for most of the producing companies, the issue isn't so much these drops, while harsh, that we've seen recently, because of course, for a lot of them, they forward sell or hedge their output. So they're really dependent or interested more in the longer term pricing trends from year to year, and those are still pretty firm. So profitability for those companies isn't particularly threatened by these shorter term corrections.
What about the threat possibly of a trade war? We've been hearing for a possible currency war as well. What effect could this have on the commodities markets?
Well, as with anything like that, someone somewhere will always lose. And if we see some of the exporting countries losing that trade war, seeing unable to weaken their currency to remain competitive, then ultimately they will stop importing these goods. And so it could have an impact on commodity prices through that route, depending on ultimately who wins any trade war that results.
So what we've seen in the last week or so is just really a blip in what is, on the longer term picture, a continuation, you think, of the bull run that we've seen?
Absolutely, but of course the thing about blips is they can sometimes be markers or signals, and what you've got to do is look at them and say, is this indicative of market nerves about the bigger picture? And there are certainly some questions about the bigger picture that's driving this, and really the verdict is still very much that we have to wait and see.
It's all about timing. Okay, all right, Nick McGregor, thanks indeed for joining us there from Redmayne Bentley.
This film is for educational and leisure purposes only. Proactive Investors does not provide investment advice. The company is a publisher and is not registered with or authorized by the Financial Services Authority. Please refer to the full terms and conditions on the Proactive Investors website.